I confess to Almighty God and to my Lord. the frequent absences of Augustus, that the whole world should be in Rome. This was the birth of Rome, when Quirinius was governor of Syria. So all went to be in Rome, each to his own town. And Joseph too went up to Galilee from the town of Nazareth to Judea, to the city of David that is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and family of David, to be enrolled with Mary, the betrothed, who was with child. While they were there, the time came for her to have her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because of the room for them in the inn. Now there were shepherds and angels living in the fields, and came to the night watch over their flock. The angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone among them, and they were struck with great fear. The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I proclaim to you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For today in the city of David a Savior has been born to you, who is Christ and Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find an infant in swaddling clothes and laying in a manger." And suddenly there was a multitude of the heavenly hosts with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
fiancé, who might have been 22, 23, wandering on the and it went to the short jaunt. Nazareth to Bethlehem would be like, if you lived on feet and you had to walk, the strong to give birth. Doesn't sound too fun, does it? And back then you had brigands, you had robbers, you had people wanted to take people's money because they knew they were going to a census. And they get to the town, and Joseph even probably had relatives, distant cousins. He was from the city, and no one would take him in. The families were afraid, and they were embarrassed at what happened. Sounds pretty common, doesn't it? But through it all, it was a holy night. Because where did Mary get birth? In a cattle stall, putting Jesus in a feed trough, the bread of life, put where animals eat. The bread of life born in Bethlehem, the city of bread. We need to let God work through the terrible Christmases to remind us there's no such thing. The fact that we're here this evening, bringing our joys and our fears, bringing our questions, bringing our anger to the Lord, is perfect. That's what the shepherds did. These were rough and ready guys from the field, minding their own business. They were seen as third-class citizens. That's why they lived with their sheep. They were the ones who were told first, come as you are to the newborn king, and for God's sake, do not be afraid. So many of us are quivering in fear. Don't be afraid. The shepherd had a lot to be afraid of. But don't be. Fear gets us nowhere. Fear gets us nowhere. That's why we have a host of angels, an army of angels, singing glory to God in the highest, to wake the shepherds up, to get their attention. Because they're in line with everyone elsewhere. What do we do? We're the same way. I gave a homily a few weeks ago to my parents, the angel of Luigi, and I said, turn on Fox News, turn off CNN, and open the Bible. So many of us have let the numbers be our God, and this, and this, and this, and this. What about the truth that Jesus Christ is with us always? What about the truth of just being smart about this? Respecting each other, moving forward. We got an email earlier this week, and a priest said, and I love it, that in the manger of Bethlehem, the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, Jesus Christ, the Alpha and the Omega of Christmas, defeats Delta and Omicron every time. Think about that. The Alpha and the Omega defeats Delta and Omicron. Once the pandemic is over and it's over, what would be the next thing that scares us? What limitation? What big news? We can either jump from ship to ship or remember the promise of this holy night, the promise of Bethlehem. I am with you always. Come to me as you are. No one is forgotten by God. Maybe some of you are just here because if you don't come to Mass, you're not going to eat and go home. That's okay. Maybe you're all these years and you go home and finally have that snort because the family is with you all. Whatever reason you're here, you're welcome. You have a home at the shrine. Because none of us are past becoming more in love with God who loves us in the wild land. None of us are so far gone that we can't come to the manger as we are for God to make us who we're meant to be. Don't let others tell you your worth. That's because they're afraid of their own or their lack of. Remember, this holy night is holy not because of angels and even shepherds or kings, but because of a simple yes. A yes to love, a yes to hope, a yes to God. A realization that we are worth more than the state we find ourselves in. It was true at the first Christmas, it's true today. We're worth so much more than we think. That's the promise of Emmanuel. God is with us. So we come and adore him. We receive him in a few moments of Holy Communion. We sing these beloved carols. And if some of you aren't Polish at all, you're at least half Polish by the time you leave this midnight mass. There's a lot more coming up. Sing the carols. Celebrate well. If you got a Skype with family, come on, Skype with them. Toast over a nice cup of coffee. Rejoice. This might not be a perfect Christmas. Good. Make it a holy one. Just like that first one was over 2,000 years ago. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
As Father Roberts was talking about, in fact, and towards the end, said, he referred to the beautiful music that the music happened in Polish. And he referred to, I guess, this doesn't mean I'm in Polish. I was just picking that up from what he just said. Just kind of sit there and do a really familiar smile and just ooh, to the melody. Because the sound that we make in our song, and especially not that which is hard driving, the soft music, takes care of the rhythm of our heart and brings us healing. Sorry, I just finally got a little joke on that. But Jesus says here, he says in the book of the chapter, what comes to this man, Jesus said, oh, says here, he's going to be here, God. Yeah, the Yako, alongside of Shatakia, Cesar, to go, Takia, give him the gemstone. So the Messiah came to Bethlehem. I dzisiejsze okazy następne celebruje światło Boga wchodzącego w świat. Historyczne Boże Narodzenie wstępiło bogactwo święto powrotu niezwyczajnego słońca po łonie ziemi. Jezus przychodzi jako światło świata. Światło radości. Światło pokój i nadziei. I boskie chwały jest tematem na dzisiejszy czytań. Więc noc radości z boskiego świata. Światło, które nas otoczyło, noc by ocenić te rzeczy i rozważać je w sercu, jak Maryja, Matki Jego. Noc towarzyszy szacom pasterze, gdy łączą się z chórem aniołów i dając chwałę Bogu. Dla nas jest dzień specjalny, dzień dzisiejszy, bo dla nas, my, którzy mamy wiarę, czy wiara jest in English, czy wiara jest po polsku, wiemy, że Bóg się rodzi. Proszę stać.
Thank you.
The joy and hope of Christmas in our hearts, we look up to God and we need prayers and intercessions.
For the Holy Father, may God grant him joy and strength as he leads the church in the ways of peace. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For elected officials, may the Holy Spirit give them grace and learning, good prudence, justice, fortitude and temperance. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all who lack stable housing, may they find strength in God and the loving support of others. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all gathered here this holy night, may Christ be formed in our hearts and guide us with his light. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, for the faithful departed, for Brother Fidelis Francisco Ministry, for whom this Mass is being offered, may their joy be full as they join the angels and saints singing, glory to God in the highest. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Ever present and faithful God, hear the prayers of your holy people as they gather around your altar on this most sacred day when Christ was born for us. Save us from all evil, and remind us our true home is in heaven. We make our prayer in his holy name. Heal us and reign with you, Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Thank you. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours be acceptable, God Almighty Father. May the oblation of this day's peace be pleasing to you, O Lord, we pray, that with the most holy exchange, we may become the likeness of Christ, in whom our nature is united to you, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
And all gathered to his faith.
are known to you, for that we offer you the sacrifice of praise of the offering for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, of health and well-being, and pay their homage to you, the eternal God living and true. Celebrate the most sacred day on which Blessed Mary, the Immaculate Virgin, brought forth the Savior for this world, and in communion with those who never be venerate, especially glory to the Virgin Mary, Mother of our God, the Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, their blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter, Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clever, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysostomus, John, and Paul, prophets, and Damian, and all your saints. We have been through their merits and prayers, and all things may be defended by your Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept the oblation of our service and of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered eternal damnation, and come among the flock of those we have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, your blessed knowledge will keep this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of the most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, the Almighty Father, giving you thanks and said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you.
Thank you. pray that one of the mercies graciously grants us share the fellowship of the holy apostles and martyrs of John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Russell, Peter, Perpetua, Felicity, Agnes, St. Agatha, Cecilia, Anastasia, Stanislaus, Bishop and Martyr, and all the saints, and also Sister Faustina and Stefan Kuczynski. We beseech you in their company, not wearing, weighing down upon our merits, granting us a heart through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them with joy.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Thank you.
Thank you.